Okay, guys, so Christmas is over and everybody's broke out there, right? And the most with everything going on in the world, it's probably the worst time for us to be able to get hands in AAA games, correct? But fear not. What's up, guys? This is your boy, Rusty, and today I'm going to teach you how to get free AAA games for your PC. But first of all, I am not going to teach you how to sell the high seas to get those games. Also, I am not going to mention any MMORPG, since we all know that, for the most part, most of those are free anyway. Alright, and number one we have Steam. Steam has one of the biggest libraries of free games, and games in general. Now, the only downside on Steam is, most games they have are not AAA games. You will find some, like Destiny for example, but those games, for the most part, because you can buy things in the store. So, while they're not MMORPGs, and no, Destiny is not an MMORPG, I don't care what people say for the most part, on this instance at least. You can get those free games. Now, I would say Steam's not the best. Well, it's number one, it's just because it's random, okay? Now you can get a lot of free games in there, it's not a bad thing, and sometimes you get some good promotions. So, hey, Steam's available, but we have better ones coming up next. And alright, at number two we have Epic Games. You guys probably remember Epic Games from the Unreal Tournament series. It is completely free to join, and not even counting, there are usually free titles every month. It's about two titles every month that you guys can download and keep forever. Some of the most remarkable games right now that you can play for free are Trackmania from Ubisoft, The Cycle Season 3, and Storm Chasers by Jaeger, Rogue Company by Hi-Rez Studios, and their flagship, they'll probably always stay on its alpha version, Unreal Tournament. Now, just so you guys have a better idea, right now, and I believe it's still January 7th, they're giving a different free game every single day. So if you guys just join Epic Store, you get those free games and just go with it. They had games like Alien Isolation coming up. They have multiple games coming out. Some are better than others, but basically it's free and you guys can enjoy the game. If you don't like it, just delete. But it's still going to stay in your library. So you can't go wrong with that, right? All right, and on number three, we have GOG, or Good Old Games. Now, while GOG don't have many actual free games, or at least not AAA titles, it does have something that brings me back to back in the day where you used to buy the PC magazines for demos. Well, that's exactly what it is. So, GOG has a lot of game demos. I think it's great. I actually miss that. And it's been like over a decade I haven't seen much, and it's because you can try the game, you try at least the first part of the game, and if you like, you know, you download the game, you don't get surprised by spending 50, 60 bucks nowadays for a game that after you pass the first stage, you realize you really don't want to play that thing. So, GOG is great for that. I don't see that much. I know Steam has some demos, but it's really not that much, at least not compared to GOG, so go check it out. All right, and on number four, we have review keys. Now, those sites are usually for game reviewers, and to actually access those keys, you need to meet certain requirements, like number of subscribers, average number of views, etc. The three I actually use are KeyMailer, Terminals by Evolve, and Woovit. I will be leaving the links in the description below. Now, good and bad things about those sites is you have to request, they'll look the number of subscribers you have, if you have a YouTube account or a Twitch account. And even if you qualify, you'll be given a certain amount of keys, you have to accept them. Now, the moment you accept, you will need to do a review. Usually you can have like 5 keys total without reviews. Past that, you cannot accept any more keys. So sometimes it's horrible because you may start playing a game and really hate it. You don't want to make a review, so you kind of can't use the site until you do it. So, ups and downs, but still, you should check it out. Now, number five is a cheat, okay? As of right now, you can get Xbox Game Pass Ultimate for $1 for the first month, and the following 2 months are free. And that actually gives you about 100 games or so to play. You can just download and play those games. Now, you don't own those games like in the Epic Store, right? And the other thing is, coming up next month, EA actually going to have their library added to the Ultimate Pass. Now, the Ultimate Pass, while it's Xbox Ultimate Pass, you can play on your PC. So now you're going to have the EA titles as well to play on PC. So that's pretty awesome for the most part. And the only reason why I'm actually keeping that as, you know, putting as free, because it only costs $1. It's $1 for 3 months and you can cancel at any time. So it's not a big deal if you decide not to play anymore. After 3 months, just cancel and you don't have to pay anything. So yeah, guys, that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notifications bell. And I hope you guys have a great day. And as always, I'll see you in the game.